Achsime und Agmachsime Teve Lono Lechol Yisroel. After Rosh Hashanah, we no longer say Achsive Vachsime Teve. Because to say to a Jew, Achsive Teve after Rosh Hashanah, the insinuation is that until now he wasn't written in the Book of the Righteous. And now we're wishing him he should be. Whereas in reality he was written already. B'Rish Hashanah Yikosevun. And on Rosh Hashanah every Jew was written for a good year. Nevertheless, the signature is on Yom Kippur, and this is why we are wishing a chasime and a gemar chasime teve lonu ulechol Yisroel. And the Rebbe tells us that together with all the brachas that we are asking, and we have every right to ask everything, because Almighty God has everything to give us, and He can give us, and He will give us. But we shouldn't forget what the Rebbe calls hanukudo hapnimis v'hatichenu, the innermost and central point. And that is to ask for the Gula Ho Amitis V'Ashlemo Lonu Ulechol Yisroel Gesundheit Umfreilichheit. And as the Rebbe gives the Rosh Tevis, and it was already mentioned on this program, and it's something that is absolutely miraculous, that 30 years ago, in the year Tovshin Nun Aleph, Parshas Vayigash, the Rebbe writes in a footnote, and it's printed in Sefer HaSeches Tovshin Nun Aleph, Parshas Vayigash, the footnote is 94, you can look it up. And there's a Rosh HaTevis there for Tovshin Pei Aleph for this year. Tehei Shnas Plois Arenu. Which means that the year the Rebbe wrote, which is absolutely mind-boggling, 30 years ago, the Rebbe wrote the Rosh HaTevis for this year. Now, which means that this is the year, Plois Arenu. Plois Arenu is a Mashiach prophecy. Like it says, Kimetzes Chomeretz Mitzrayim, Arenu Niflois. It's a Pesach in Micho. It's a Mashiach prophecy. And therefore, the Rebbe says, on this year, 30 years ago, the Rebbe said, on this year, which is, as mentioned, absolutely mind-boggling, especially this year, Tehei Shnas Plois Arenu. And if you permit me, a poetic license, or even a little bit of a poetic license. 30 years ago, Tovshin Nun Aleph. So the Rebbe said then, Tehei Shnas Niflois Arenu. Now it's not Niflois Arenu, now it's Plois Arenu. It says it's for him, the Rebbe mentioned it many times, that Niflois means Nun Plois, 50 Plois. However, that's Tovshin Nun Aleph. Tovshin Pei Aleph, it doesn't say how many. It's Plois Arenu, which means it's even higher than Tovshin Nun Aleph. Because Tovshin Nun Aleph, how many Plois was it? 50. Now, 50 Plois is a lot. Nevertheless, 50 is a numerical number. It means 50 and not 51. And definitely not 100 and definitely not 200. It's 50. Yes, it's not less than 50, but it's also not more than 50. Nevertheless, when we say Tehei Shnas Plois without a number, it's Ein Mispor. It means Plois without a number. In other words, there is no limit to the Plois of this year. And this is exactly what Kmeit says, Chom Eretz Mitzrayim Arenu Niflois. And the Rebbe says that the inner pshat of the Pasuk is, not only are we going to see miracles, as we saw in the times when we went out of Mitzrayim, it also means that we are going to see miracles that are even compared to the miracles of Mitzrayim, they are going to be miracles. It's even miracles as compared to miracles. Even compared to the great miracles, and we know the great miracles of Yetzias Mitzrayim, everybody knows that. Nevertheless, the miracles that we're going to see now are going to be miracles even as compared to the miracles of Mitzrayim, and that is the Geulah HaAmitis V'Ashlemo, coming our way, Gesundheit und Freilichkeit, Tekef U'Miyad Mamish. On Thursday is Vov Tishrei, the Yotzeit of Rabbonis HaTzitkon Ischana Nishmoso Eden, the Rebbe's mother. Following after that, Monday is Yom Kippur. On Yom Kippur, it says, and we're now in Aseret Yimei Tshuva, that Yom Kippur is Achas Bashono. The Posuk in Tetzaveh, the very last Posuk, as a matter of fact, it says two times in that Posuk, Achas Bashono. Yom Kippur is Achas Bashono. You will ask a Jew, what does Achas Bashono mean? What is the definition of Achas Bashono? And he will say, what kind of question is this? Achas means once. Yom Kippur is once a year. Look up the calendar. And if he wants to be a smart aleck Jew from the Chachmei Lijonke, and he says Yom Kippur is once a year, thank God. How many times a year do you want me to fast for my sins? Yom Kippur is once a year. Nevertheless, there is a deeper esoteric pshat as to what Achas Bashono means. We will return to that in a moment. But first, our customary story, or in this case, stories. Mentioned before that on Thursday is Vov Tishrei, the Yovtzeit of Rabbonis Atzitkonis Chano, Nishmoso Eden, the Rebbe's mother. I remember many times, this I heard from her several times, 3-4 times maybe, that she said, you be nit nor abas tal mit chochem, you be necha neshes chover. There is a big, great distinction of being a bas talmid chochem, the daughter of a talmid chochem. There's also a great distinction of being the wife of a talmid chochem. So the Rebbetzin would say she's not only a bas talmid chochem, and her father, the Meir Shleimer, was a goyin. Nevertheless, she's also an eishes chover. She's also the wife of a great talmid chochem, and she said it with real pride. She also told a story, which later I saw was printed. So therefore I'm free to tell it, that it seems this was after the shidduch between the Levi Yitzchak and her. And ich habe gewollt, dass er soll tragen a schlappe. I wanted you should wear a schlappe. A schlappe is a hat like we wear. And until then he was wearing a casket. But the Rebbetzin says that she wanted he should wear a schlappe, and he didn't want. And it seems there were some negotiations. And because he didn't want. And then the Rebbetzin said, with a half smile, "Und ich hab es gefühlt," and I had my way. That's what she said, but with a smile and with great satisfaction. Later I heard that, and that's printed someplace already, that the Levi Yitzchak asked the Rebbe Nishma Seiden what he should do. Should he wear a schlappe or not? And the Rebbe Nishma Seiden answered him, he should listen to the Rebbe Sanchane, and he should wear a schlappe. And it's not a contradiction at all to what the Rebbe Sanchane said. She told the story from her perspective, from what she knows, that she asked him to wear a schlappe, and at first he didn't want, and there was some talk about it, and as the Rebbe said, und ich hab es gefühlt, and she had her way. The Rebbe also told the story with great sadness that it was the last year that the Rebbe was in Yekaterinoslav before he got married. And she would say, Seider Tate und Seider Sohn, that the father and the son both knew that this is the last Simchas Torah that they are going to be together in this world. However, the father didn't reveal that to the son, and the son didn't reveal it to the father. The father didn't say it to the son didn't say it to the father. And what did they do? Sie haben getanzt und getanzt und getanzt. They danced and danced and danced. Rabbi, concerning the question or the definition of Yom Kippur, Achas Bashono, so there is a Kabbalah in Sfarim of Kabbalah that Achas Bashono means that Achas is a reference to one. Of course, it means once a year, but it's deeper than that. On Yom Kippur is the revelation of Achas. Achas is the one. What is the one? It's the part of the neshama that's called Yechida. The neshama has five parts, Kabbalistically. Nefesh, Ruach, Neshama, Chayo, Yechida. Yechida means one. It's that one, and the explanation is in the classic Kabbalistic Sefer, Eitz Chaim, that yesh nitzutz koton, there's one spark of godliness, and this spark is the nitzutz, it's the nitzutz boyle, the nitzutz of the Creator. And what happened is what happens is the nitzutz boyle becomes one with the nitzutz nivro. Achas means that one nitzutz that is hidden deep in our soul, and that is called yechido. That one nitzutz then becomes united with the one nitzutz of nitzutz beiri, which means the nitzutz nivro, the spark of the creation, of the person who is created, and the spark of the creator, the one who created everything, are united on this one day. So the achas is the very innermost, the deepest part of the neshama, and that is called achas, and on Yom Kippur is the revelation of that achas. And the unity of the achas of the Jew with the inner part of the Jew with the inner part of Almighty God Himself. And one would say it's from Eitz Chaim, and it's a Kabbalah Sefer, which is absolutely wonderful. But the Rebbe brings that we also find it in Nigla. We find it in the Gemara in Menachos, where Tosfos says that. Let's open up the Gemara in Menachos. It's Daf Yud Ches Amud Aleph, and it's interesting. A small Tosfos, Ad Achas, and Tosfos says, Ad Achas Ad HaNefesh Shenikra'as Yechido. Which Tosfos here is in concert with what says in Eitz Chaim, that Ad Achas, it's that part, Ad Achas Ad HaNefesh Shenikra'as Yechido, the part of the Nefesh that is called Yechido. So therefore, there is a unity on Yom Kippur between the part of the Nefesh, Achas of the Nefesh, that is the Nitzutz Nivro, and that becomes united with the Nitzutz Beirei, and that's the Achas of the Jew and the Achas of Almighty God. And this leads to another achas, because it says also in Sforim of Kabbalah that in general terms, Moshiach is the Yechido HaKlolis, the Yechido of the general Yechido of the world, the Yechido there is the way it is in the Nefesh, and that is the microcosm in the small picture of each individual. Then Yechido is the innermost part of the Neshama. In the macrocosm, in the big picture, what is the Yechido of the world? The Yechido of the world is Moshiach. So that what we see here is that not only is there a revelation of the inner part of the Jew, the Achas of the Jew, together with the Achas of Almighty God, and that what Achas Bashono really means, that is the deep esoteric explanation of the word achas, and this is also connected with the general achas, Yechido HaKlol is the general achas, and that is Moshiach. Now you are going to say, yes, we accept that, but where do we find proof to it in a way that we can also understand it? Yes, you're telling me that this is a Kabbalistic idea. Wonderful, we'll accept it. But is there a way that we can relate to it? Well, Rabbi Isai, there is a way that each and every single one of us can relate to it. That what is the ultimate reason and what happens at the ultimate height of Yom Kippur? Let's see. On Yom Kippur, Rabbi Isai, we have five tefillahs. Just learned in the Rambam. There are some days there are three tefillahs, some days there are four tefillahs, and one day, Achas Bashono, there are five tefillahs. Every day there are three, on Shabbos and Yontif there are four, Shemin Esrus, Shachris Mincha and Ma'ariv, and on Shabbos and the Shchedesh there are four Shemin Esrus. And then there is once a year, Achas Bashono, there are five tefillahs. And that is on Yom Kippur. Now, which is the highest of the tefillahs? Now, it's difficult for us to judge, but everybody knows that the highest, the zenith of the tefillahs, the high point of the tefillahs, is tefillahs nila. That is the is ne'ilah sha'ar. And the explanation is that ne'ilah, what does ne'ilah mean? What are we locking? We are locking the doors. And it's explained also in Sforim of Kabbalah, we're locking the doors for everyone. No one can get in, only Almighty God and the Jews. It's only you and us. On Yom Kippur to Nila. And the gates to heaven are open. Now, Yom Kippur also to Nila, we build up. We say the Shemoneh Esrei and then and the Chazoros HaShatz and Avinu Malkeinu. And then we come to the highlight, to the very end of Nila. To the very end of Nila, we scream out with all our might, Shema Yisroel Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. And it says in Sforim, and it's also printed in Machzor, that at that moment, we should think that we are ready to give away our lives for the sanctification of Almighty God. Now, we don't have to give away our lives the way our forefathers did, in the literal sense. But we're giving away our thoughts and we're giving away our will. We're giving away our want. We're giving away our desires to Almighty God. And once we think about it, Almighty God accepts it as if it happens and it doesn't have to happen in a physical way. It's only in a spiritual way. Shema Yisroel Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. And you can hear that the walls in Shul are trembling. All Jews are screaming, Shema Yisroel Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. We do it once. Then it says, we say three times, Baruch Shem Kved Malchus Le'ilom Void. And if that is not enough, then we say, we scream, Hashem Hu Ha'alikim. Almighty God is the one. Almighty God is, He is the master ruler. How many times do we say that? Seven times. We say it seven times. The Chazan says it seven times. And after that, there's a Kaddish. After the Kaddish, there is a Tkiyok Delo, and that is already the highlight of the highlights. But that's not all. After the Tkiyok Delo, we make one big announcement. And what is that announcement? Yechido HaKlolis, Moshiach, Lashono Habo Birushalayim, which means after all the Aveda of Chedosh Elul, after sounding the shofar every day, and after saying three kapitlin, and after Rosh Hashanah, and after Aseres Yemei Teshuva, and after Yom Kippur, and after the five tefillahs of Yom Kippur, what is the highlight of everything? Lashono Habo Birushalayim, we want Mashiach now. And this is now we can understand that this is the connection of Achas Bashono, the Yechida HaKlolis, the general Yechida of the world, is Moshiach. So now we are connecting the Nitzutz Nivro, that is the spark of the Nivro, of the creation, together with the Nitzutz Beiri, the spark of the Creator, together with Yechida HaKlolis, the general Yechida, which is Moshiach, and that comes all together on Yom Kippur, and by Nilev we scream, Lashono Habo Birushalayim. And especially this year, Rabbi Say, this year, when the Rosh HaTevis is the Hey Shnas Plois Alenu, and the Rebbe says, Plois Alenu explains. You can see it, it's in Haggadah 94, printed in Sefer HaSichas, Parshas Vayigas, Tovshin Nun Aleph, Haggadah 94. And this is also in a parenthesis. So the Rebbe hid it. But Baruch Hashem, someone found it. And what is the message? The Hei Shnas Plois Alenu, that the Plois, which it's seen as mentioned before, Plois without a mispor, without a number. Like it says, V'ligdudov ein mispor. There's some things that have numbers, and there's some things that have no numbers, that are beyond numbers, that are endless, that are infinite. So the Niflois are endless and infinite. This is the year, Tehei Shnas Plois, but the Rebbe says that the Plois should be Alenu. We should be able to see it, with our very own eyes, Beini Bosol, that we should see all together the Gula Ho Amitis V'Ashlemo, Gesundheit und Freilichheit, Plois Alenu, Beini Bosol, with our very, very physical eyes, Gesundheit und Freilichheit, ובעגולו דידן, ובשמחו ובטוב ליבוב, ובטבע נילה והניגלו, למטה מעשור הטפוחים, ובחסד וברחמים, ותקף ומיד ממש.